Save your
my God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever on the rock salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty. He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. He is mighty to save.
Pastor's all looking cheery and chip, but she still barely has a voice. So I think some of us along the way are going to do some things she would normally do. But welcome to everybody. Whether you come usually or you don't come usually, it's really great to have everybody here to worship this morning. And I invite you to take out your bulletin papers, and if you aren't already on the first printed page, and we're going to sing together, Open the Eyes of My Heart, Lord. Invocation, which means calling the Holy Spirit into our midst and into our hearts, we're going to sing hopefully a song that's familiar to most of us. Please just join in prayerfully as we ask the Holy Spirit to come into us.
My heart. morning. Can you hear me all right?
Yep, you're right on it.
Am I right on it? What do you mean? Oh, I have to be right on it. Thank you. I'm so sorry. Well, good morning. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who stretches out the heavens, who sends light to all the nations, and who gives breath to us all.
Amen. Amen.
Let us come into the light of Christ, confessing our need for God's mercy. Found in your insert at the top. Let's say that together. O God, eternal goodness, immeasurable love, you place your gifts before us. We eat and are satisfied. Fill us and this world and all its need with the life that comes only from you, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We'll now listen to the word of God. Morning. First lesson comes from the 16th chapter of Exodus, selected verses. The whole congregation of the Israelites complained against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. The Israelites said to them, "If only we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. For you have brought us out into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I am going to rain bread from heaven for you, and each day the people shall go out and gather enough for that day. In that way I will test them, whether they will follow my instruction or not." Then Moses said to Aaron, "Say to the whole congregation of the Israelites, draw near to the Lord, for he has heard your complaining." And as Aaron spoke to the whole congregation of the Israelites, they looked toward the wilderness, and the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, "I have heard the complaining of the Israelites. Say to them, at twilight you shall eat meat, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread. Then you shall know that I am the Lord your God." In the evening, quails came up and covered the camp, and in the morning there was a layer of dew around the camp. When the layer of dew lifted, there was on the surface of the wilderness a fine, flaky substance, as fine as frost on the ground. When the Israelites saw it, they said to one another, "What is it?" For they did not know what it was. Moses said to them, "It is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat." Please say responsively the 78th Psalm. So God commanded the clouds above and opened the doors of heaven. So mortals ate the bread of the angels. God provided for them food enough. Raining down flesh upon them like dust and flying birds, like the sand of the seas. So the people ate and were filled, for God gave them what they craved. The second lesson is from the 4th chapter of Ephesians. I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. But each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore, it is said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive. He gave gifts to his people. When it says he ascended, what does it mean but that he also descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who de-ascended is the same as the one who ascended far above all the heavens, so that he might fill all things.
The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness and deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love. Here ends the lesson.
Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 6th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were beside the sea, they themselves got into the boats and went to Capernaum looking for Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for your eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For it is on him that God the Father has set his seal." Then they said to him, "What must we do to perform the works of God?" Jesus answered them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent." So they said to him, "What sign are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing? Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written, 'He gave them bread from heaven to eat.'" Then Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." They said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. A few things have come to mind this morning as we sit out on this beautiful, beautiful lawn in front of our beautiful, beautiful church. I don't know if you can still see it, but there was dew still on the grass when we came here. Maybe there still is some. Will caught a frog, so we know that the dew is really attracting all sorts of creatures. But that dew is like the manna, right, that we read in our first lesson. And God provides. And it's just amazing to think that even now, 2021, God continues to provide for us, just like he did the Israelites all those thousands and thousands of years ago. It is truly amazing. I have to say, this is a good story. Trust me. There was a Lutheran seminary out in West Denmark. I don't know if you guys knew that. Do you guys know where West Denmark is? Of course. Silly me. We lived so close to West Sweden, we gotta know where West Denmark is, right? Well, of course. But did you know that there was a Lutheran seminary there? Okay, Karen knew. Did anybody else? It's shocking to most people. There we go. Yeah. Most people do not know that. And think of that. That was where the Danes in this country sent their people to become pastors.
right in our own backyard. All that's left now is a wooden sign that says, hey, there was a seminary here, don't forget, right? In his book, Gordon Lathrop, who is kind of the ELCA's liturgical guru, I was surprised to find that he said that there is a North American Danish Lutheran congregation in Luck, Wisconsin. How bizarre. In the 19th century, expressed what its worship was like by putting an inscription on its church bell. When the bell rang, inviting people to church, this congregation hoped that people would know that this is what the bell was saying. This is what is inscribed on the bell. To the bath and the table, to the prayer and the word, I call every seeking soul. Curious, isn't it? I call every seeking soul. Of course, what does it mean when we say to the bath and to the table? Baptism and Holy Communion. And I know you guys might be getting sick of me saying this, and don't worry, we just have 3 more weeks of this John's passage of the bread of life, but you can never hear it enough, I think. That the table that God sets before us is extremely holy. No matter if it's inside, outside, here, there, wherever, makes no difference. My pastor always said you could do communion with just chips and soda if you really, really needed to. Right. It's true, though. We could. My question today is, what does it mean to solely rely on God? What would happen if we lived our lives as though we could not survive without God? What would happen? That is the reason the church, us, the gathered people of God, have referred to the church as a hospital. Because what did Jesus say? I came to heal the sick. Those who are righteous have no need of a physician. So regularly, the people of God gather. We gather around the font, around the table, and rejoice in the power of the Word of God. Now, we think all the way back to the Exodus today in our reading, where the Israelites were wandering around in the desert. They were hungry and thirsty. They grumbled and complained. God gave them water from a rock and the manna, the bread, from heaven. That same God continues to shower his creation with bread. It is no coincidence, after all, that Jesus was born in Bethlehem, which means the house of bread. Because, as he says today, he is the bread of life. The bread we break together every Sunday gives us life eternal. Every Sunday we hear Jesus say, take and eat. Take me, he says. I have given you my whole body so that you may live. And what is our response? We exclaim, just like the crowd of thousands of years ago, you know, Jesus, that's kind of a tricky teaching. Really nobody can understand it. It's kind of far-fetched. It's way out there. So we grumble and we complain. We ask God for more signs, like the crowd, like the people we read about today. They said, wait, where did Jesus go? And they search for him. And when they find him, they say, Jesus says to them, you are not looking for me because you are looking for a sign, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. It's almost like Jesus knew then that this would have to be a repetitious thing for us to fully understand the fact that he is the bread of life. He is what gives us life. Gandhi, it's always funny when someone quotes Gandhi, because they always sound so wise and everything. But Gandhi does say, who, if you don't know, was Hindu. He studied the Bible and was actually a huge follower of Christ, but was not Christian. He said, there are so many hungry people in the world that God could only come in the world in the form of food. It is marvelous that God would enter our lives, not just in the form of sermons or Bibles, but in food. So, dear friends, I ask that when you hear the bell, when you hear that people are gathering in God's name, when you hear the forgiveness that Christ gives us, think of that inscription on the bell, not that far away from us. To the bath and the table, to the prayer and the word, I call every seeking soul. Ways. For those of you who don't know, this week is VBS, Vacation Bible School here, kind of in part why we're outside and celebrating. But the memory verse, the main verse that these kids will memorize this week is that wonderful verse that we just sang, they'll know we are Christians by our love. Jesus says, you know, do these things because people will know you by the signs of love. So how amazing is that? God works in mysterious ways. At this time, I'll ask you to please rise. We gather our hearts as all Christians gather around our confession that God is good. Let us confess the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Rooted in Christ and sustained by the Spirit, We offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all of creation. Lord, you call your church to be the body of Christ. Awaken all the baptized to the gifts you provide for carrying out the work of ministry. Where the church is divided, knit us together and restore the unity of the faith. Lord, in your mercy. You command the clouds above and cause the wind to blow in the heavens. You breathe new life into us. Watch over your creation. We pray for those combating the wildfires, and we pray for healing where destruction has taken place. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those who govern. Cast out arrogance, selfishness, and corruption, and instruct those who lead to practice compassion and humility. Inspire them with a vision of the common good and a commitment to ensure that all who hunger are fed. Lord, in your mercy. You draw near to those who cry out for help. Feed those who are hungry, reassure those who are despairing, and accompany those who are imprisoned. Rain down the true bread from heaven that gives life to the world. Be with all those in need, including those on our prayer list, Nora Anderson, Bruce and Lori Paulson, Mauricio Trujillo, Josephine Silva, and Jane, the secretary, Bethany. Lord, all of these, we ask for you to surround them with your unwavering presence. Lord, in your mercy. You receive all who come seeking a sign of grace. Make this congregation a place of hospitality for those who are accustomed to rejection. To those who have felt excluded here because of our thoughts or actions, forgive us and prepare us to welcome them in the name of Christ. Lord, in your mercy. You provide food that endures for eternal life. Sustain us each day with the bread of life until we are gathered, along with St. Dominic, Maxine Lindquist, Betty Leish, and all the saints, and feast together at your heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy. We lift these and all our prayers to you, O God, confident in the promise of your saving love, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
I should have looked ahead. Sorry, because this is the time when you'll get up and shake other people's hands and say peace. So that's exciting. You could do that now if you want. You could also be cognizant.
You know what else is cool? This is actually our first contemporary service actually with Pastor. She was here right when she got here. We did one and we just did our deal. And then we didn't gather anymore for all these months, as we all know.
So sorry about that. Yes, I printed the wrong thing. Real quick, though, I have to say, for offering, there is a basket right there, the offering plate. Please do greet it on your way out. I should say, VBS, the offering challenge for them this week is World Hunger, the ELCA's organization that helps thousands of people struggling to find food and water. So if you find it in your hearts to give to them and to their cause, please do so. With that said, please rise. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Holy, mighty, and merciful God, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who, on the cross, opened his arms for all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave it to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share in this heavenly food, which is the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. You may be seated. So this is how we are going to do this today. We have a whole tray of those paper cups. You simply pick them up, one of them up, put it in the palm of your hand. I will then take the wafer, dip it in the chalice, and place it in that thing that you're holding on the palm of your hand. So don't worry, just go with the flow, it's okay. Come to the Lord's table, come and see that the Lord is good, and that he continues to feed you.
Woman or man, no more.
and we the many. Throughout you, we are one body in this one. Bring for the fields, scattered and grown, gathered to
body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Announcements, announcements. Where do we even begin? First off, we need to give a big round of applause for our worship leaders. Oh. Worship. They have spent many, many hours preparing for this. They make it look flawless and easy, but it takes lots and lots of practice. So thank you, guys.
And a big thank you to Phil for setting all this
yes.
up.
Truly. Wow. Phil is the guy, always, yeah. always. As I stated earlier, today is the beginning of Pilgrims VBS. We're very excited. The theme is God's gift of water, or the river of life, depending on how you look at it. And if you did not have a chance to get enough singing out or to get enough fun out or be outside enough today, then come back at 5 o'clock and you will not be disappointed. We will have fire. What else are we going to have, Lisa? Do you not want to say anything?
We'll have fire if we could find the fire pit.
Oh, did you hear that? We need to find the fire pit. Does anybody know where that is? If so, please talk to Lisa Jensen, please, because we want that for tonight, for them to grill or to roast Marlowe's, you know? We're also going to grill. There's going to be hot dogs and everything. Every night this week, I should say tonight through Wednesday from 5 to 7, dinner will be offered. And it is just very, very exciting for our kids to come together and learn about God. Next week, we will share those photos with you, so please stay tuned. Another announcement, we are extremely excited to be welcoming our new youth associate. This person will be with us 20 hours a week for a whole year. They come from Luther Point Bible Camp, and we will welcome that person on September 1st. We do not know who that person is yet, so pray. Pray. This upcoming Friday and Saturday at Bethany, they are having their annual pie and books social. Please stop by and support them in that. There's hundreds of books to choose from, and I hope there's also hundreds of pies. So that is this Friday from 9 to 4 p.m. and then Saturday 9 to noon. Next Sunday, Luther Point Bible Camp will be hosting their annual quilt auction. Bruce, do you have anything to add to that?
Please come out to Luther Point.
Hey, there we go. There, that's simple. So,
and I would like to say something, Bill.
Yeah.
We, as a church, now, we have for the silent auction, Karen Persico, who is an excellent knitter,
yes,
donated 5 items a lap that was like 50 by 60, I think, and four sweaters. They were just beautiful. Oh, wow. And so I took them out there, had to fill up the cart, and took them out there on Friday and talked to Al.
Oh, yes.
And so in talking with Al, he says to me, I was talking about Pastor Catherine. He says,
I'm Pastor Emily.
I'm sorry.
I get that from time to time. That's okay.
He said that you were his student.
Yes. Al Arndt was my dear, dear teacher in high school. Kind of a figurehead. And he's the treasurer there. And you, or what are you then, if you're not the treasurer?
I'm the treasurer.
Oh, I don't know what he does. Oh, finance manager.
And so I have two other announcements after that.
Okay, for sure.
Just a reminder about the food shelf. Bring food every Sunday, whatever you want to bring for the food shelf. And the other thing is that Joan Funy has invited us to come down there in White Bear Lake and ride on the pontoon. So any of you women that want to go, I've got dates for August. So let me know that you want to come. Either by phone or afterwards or whatever. So let me know, and then we can discuss and come up with a date that's good for all of us. That's the end of my announcements.
Thank you so much, Carol. That is very exciting. Lots going on here. With that said, please rise and receive God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thanks be to God.